These guys over here are booing already. Hello and welcome to the sixth eviction night of Big Brother. This week Big Brother made anchors out of all the housemates as their task was to host and run BBTV, a special television channel that allowed the housemates messages from the outside world. The housemates learned about the Beckham's departure to LA, Kieran Richardson's departure to Sunderland, and as nominations were announced, the imminent departure of either Charlie or Tracy. Oh, and in other news, two became one as Chiggy did the dirty push-push. Or did they? Anyway, tonight's going to be big, it's going to be huge. That's what Ziggy said. Again, not only will the house lose either Tracy or Charlie, they will gain a handful of playmates, as Big Brother sends a shiny new batch in tonight in our second show of the evening. But before all of that, listen, you, shiny people at home, you've got a little bit of a job to do. To evict Charlie, call 09011-212204. 09011-212204. Or to evict Tracy, call 09011-212211. 09011-212211, at least 10 pence from each call. It's going to get donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother. Right, line's going to close at 19 minutes past nine. Let's get back to day 58. And Chanel, Ziggy and Charlie have a heart-to-heart in the caravan. Well, sort of.
Day 58, 10:38 a.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Well, I think I'll do a condom teach today. And a little questionnaire. Some questions, they should all know it. Just in case they don't, I will fill in the gaps. If they have a sexy time when they leave here, we want to have a safe time.
Brian and Ziggy are in the garden.
I like Chanel.
Yeah.
I do, and also, you know, I enjoy her company, but, exactly. You know, I'm not going to marry the girl, I'm not going to, you know, exactly. Who knows what's going to happen when we leave here, but...
Exactly, you don't know what's going to happen.
What? But, I mean, it's gone way too far as I wanted it to in here, you know, it's gone way over the top.
You are literally, think about it, you've had a span of whole entire relationship in the Big Brother House.
Yeah, Big Brother House.
You got with someone, you went out with someone, you broke up with someone, and you sort of got back.
Yeah.
How many people can say they've done that?
I don't know. And it's been intense, man. You've got to understand, I don't, you know, there are times when I sit there and I look at you boys and I wish that, you know, I was doing what you and Liam were doing.
True, but then, I don't know. Then
in the way of that, you know, I'm nobody's in the way of, because it's not
that. You're a free person.
It's just, you know.
It's that, I know that whole sort of domestics.
Yeah, she does shitloads for me. She makes you sandwiches, she makes you tea, exactly. Makes me coffee, but... But people don't want to see that side because they just don't want to see it.
I think it's obvious how much she... I think it's obvious you two are good, not just that, you're friends.
We're good mates.
Do you know what I'm trying to say?
What?
I said, that's what I'm saying. It's like, it's obvious that you're friends and you wouldn't put up with it if you didn't want to. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, of course, but I'm a big person and
yeah.
You know, it's... She's... We have a... You know, I actually... If I came in this house and said, oh, I want to spend my time with someone... She'd be at the top of the list because
yeah,
she's fun, she's very funny.
That's what I'm saying.
She's a girl, man. Why wouldn't I possibly want to sit in a bed with a girl?
I think that's one thing me and Liam both would like to have.
But I'll be honest with you, bro. I genuinely cannot wait to get out of here and have some space.
I know you can't.
PM. Liam, Chanel, Carol and Amanda are at the dining table. Housemates have been working on this week's shopping list for the past 17 minutes.
Right, can we have... Let's have a look. Oh, can we have some cotton? No, I'm kidding. I haven't got to ask for condoms. Can we have some shower gel? I'm joking.
Well, do you want a lime?
Please.
Brian is in the garden.
Bloody hell. Ready.
Tracy is in the diary room.
packing is in the front of my mind. Get my shit together and having to go through that front door, maybe. But yeah, that's what's on my mind. I'm sure it's on Charlie's as well, you know. But you know, it's 50-50 really between me and her, I think. I mean, the public might want an argumentative person in here who keeps it a bit on the ball, as it were.
Tracy, how would you describe your Big Brother experience?
Amazing. Unforgettable. I'd do it all again if I had the chance. I've loved every second of it. You're going to make me cry now. No, it's unforgettable, isn't it? Thousands of people try and get to this place, and I've been a very lucky person to get here. I've been here for, nearly 9 weeks. So I think it's an achievement. But like I say, if I have to go, I have to go, don't I?
PM. Brian, Liam and Sam are in the living area on the fish phone to no one.
I think what's happened is he's got himself a bit carried away. I think he's got something on his mind. I think maybe a girl. Amanda, I think. Maybe Amanda's taken over his brain.
Amanda is in the diary room ordering this week's shopping.
Well, I was just wondering, do you think we could get a pink hair dye up? Because there's a blonde streaking kit, but instead of a blonde one, getting a pink one up, do you have to, like, ask for pink before?
Big Brother will endeavour to get some pink hair dye if you wish to add it to the shopping list at a price of £4.95.
Yes, I'll put...
If, however, Big Brother is unable to get the pink hair dye, this amount will be deducted from the shopping list and you will not be able to use that money for anything else.
I'll put it on.
Ziggy is in the caravan. Charlie is at the smoking area.
Right, we'll have to say.
What's that?
This festival would be very boring without you.
Well, that's just the thing, Ziggy, but, you know, you don't. No one thinks about that before they book up a fiction, so that's just too bad.
Well, no, because that's how people feel. If they want to do something, they do it.
I've got my ideas who it was, and do you want me to tell you something? Then people couldn't phrase me in the slightest bit, and I'm only being honest, but at the same time, it's kind of like, no one realises that. Amanda was practically breaking down yesterday. As much as you think I intimidate them two twins, I think they idolise me, to be honest with you, Ziggy. I've not had one argument, and it's like, if I didn't have an argument with you, and everyone was being so rude, I'd like you, but at the same time, if that makes any sense to you.
No, I don't know, personal arguments. I don't just like comments, some comments that you come out with.
Fair enough.
That's my issue with you.
My point is, Amanda was practically breaking down in tears yesterday. She's like, Charlie, I don't know what I'm going to do when you're gone. I don't want you to go. It's going to be so shit about you. If I had to say that, bless her little heart. And that's, she genuinely meant it. She was breaking down. I don't think it would be boring about me. I think
the dynamics would be. I think there'll be no arguments. That's what I do think.
Yeah, it'd be a nice group then. That's something needs to be. Arguments. I'm through with it, mate. I'm generally through with it. If they told me that Tracy was going over me, I was crying my eyes out and go, I'll leave the programme.
I have a funny feeling Tracy won't go over you.
No, she's going to stay over me.
I have a funny feeling that she may be the one to go.
No, she won't. Listen, when there's two people at night...
Definitely.
Yeah, because she knows it's right piss off you said that.
What?
When there's two people...
I don't want Tracy to go, really.
No, but I've said this before to you. I think maybe Charlie will be kept in. I do.
If Tracy goes over me, yeah, I promise you not, I'll go in the next day. I will walk out of this program. I've told them that. They're fiction. Like, I can't be bothered no more. But I think I've made enough impact in this house for me to be bothered about if I go. Some people have left and ain't even remembered. Me, I think I'll be remembered for maybe the wrong reasons, but who gives a shit?